Next, write down Graham's law of diffusion. Diffusion or effusion? Write down in this. Definition of diffusion, you write down. Write down. Diffusion, it is a tendency of any gas. It is the tendency of any gas to occupy. Tendency of any gas to occupy the available volume. To occupy the available volume. Next line, it occurs in solid and liquid as well. Solid and liquid as well as in gases. But the rate is maximum for gaseous molecule. Faster, yes. Rate means per unit time we are talking about, right? Anything, if I talk about rate, like you see, what is the definition of speed? It is the rate of change of distance. Rate of change of distance. So distance per unit time is speed, right? Displacement per unit time is velocity. So rate of change of displacement is velocity. Whenever we have rate, we'll calculate per unit time. Okay, so rate of any reaction is the rate of change of concentration of that reactant or product. Okay, so rate of diffusion is what? The rate of rate at which the process is taking place. Okay, suppose a gas is moving from high to low pressure zone. So at what speed, at what pace the process is taking place? That is the rate of that process. Okay, so next write down. It can also be defined as the tendency of. It can also be defined as the tendency of gaseous molecule to move from high pressure to low pressure until the partial pressure becomes equal, okay? Next line, the rate of diffusion or effusion.
So, but here partial pressure means the partial pressure of each container.
Partial pressure means the gaseous particle that is moving, pressure of that gaseous particle. Suppose, in we have a container connected like this.
Basically, okay. The pressure of each container is the same.
Not each container we cannot. So suppose A and B two mixture we have here.
Yes.
A and B will have here also, right? So A molecules moves towards B, high to low pressure, according to the partial pressure of A in this container and in this container.
Okay.
Suppose B pressure is more here, less over here, then B moves from this side to this side, according to its pressure. A pressure more here, less here, then A moves from this side to this side. High pressure to low pressure.
So the partial pressure of each gas, each container becomes equal.
No, whatever the gas is diffusing, pressure of that gas. Okay, pressure of that gas.
So, but
obviously, when you have mixture like this, then we have to see the total pressure here and total pressure here. According to that, the gaseous particles moves from this side to this side or in the reverse.
But if only one of them,
is there, then the pressure of that gas. Okay, that's what it means. Now you see, diffusion and effusion are actually the same thing. There's no like if you have numerical question, then there's no difference in calculating the rate of diffusion or rate of effusion. Definition is a bit different. Effusion is what if you have a tube, right, in which the air is present, filled up completely. When you make a small hole into that, the air particles comes out, right? That is the process of effusion. Okay, but when it bursts, that is diffusion. Bursting is diffusion. See, effusion is the movement of movement of gaseous particles, gaseous molecules, through small hole or tiny hole. So puncture is effusion, a small hole effect. Bursting is diffusion. Okay.
So this is
effusion.
So this bulb thing is
effusion. This is effusion. Movement of gases particles through a tiny hole.
So the bulb is effusion.
Wait, this is.
So what is bulb?
It's tiny. It's actually. Wait, that's
one. So the bulb is effusion.
Bulb.
So that's
the bulb question. No. See, if you have a balloon, ठीक है, balloon है. Assume कर लो ये balloon, ठीक है. इसमें एक मैंने थोड़ा सा hole किया. So the gases particles come out. That is effusion.
No, sir, he's asking that example.
No, this is not effusion. This is a mixing of gas.
It's a small hole.
It is connected with a tube, right? And the gases partly from this side to this side. This I explained when the pressure of that particular gases we are considering, high to low pressure, right? But suppose you have a balloon, right? If you make a hole in the balloon, a small hole in the pin, the gases particles comes out, that is effusion. But when you burst it, that is diffusion. Diffusion is a very important example when you mount cook in the kitchen, no? You get the, you know, or the perfume fragrance that you get. That is also diffusion.
So
right.
Bursting, so it moves through the air.
No, bursting. It's something like from one particular container, the gases molecules are going out. So when you make a small hole, the particles comes out through that hole, right? So one by one they are coming. But when you burst it out, all of a sudden they are diffused. So diffusion rate is a bit faster than effusion. The only difference we have in definition. Effusion is the movement of gaseous particles from a tiny hole, and this is what the burst is when it moves. Or another way, the fragrance of perfume. I use here, and you'll get even in the kitchen if someone comes, you'll get the fragrance of perfume. That is also diffusion. Okay, diffusion rate of, write down next time, rate of diffusion. Diffusion or effusion. It is inversely proportional to the square root of density.
Density
of the gaseous particle which is diffusing or effusing. Okay? Okay, now rate, you see, this is the relation we have, experimental relation. Rate we can define in many different ways, and it is equals to the volume diffused per unit time. In terms of volume, we can define volume diffused per unit time. We can also define the number of moles diffused per unit time. Per unit time. Or we can also define distance traveled or distance per unit time. In terms of distance, in terms of moles, in terms of volume, we can define the rate. So any one of this relation you can use according to the given question. Suppose the first one we see, if we say for two gases, for two gases equal volume diffuses in different time. Okay. Suppose we'll have gas A and its V volume diffuses in time T1. Gas B it's again V volume, because equal volume we have, diffuses in time T. So rate of A, rate of diffusion of A is equals to V divided by T1, right? And rate of B is what? V divided by T2, okay? If I take the ratio of these two, rate of A divided by rate of B is equals to root over of density of B by density of A, which is again equals to this volume and this volume gets cancelled, so we'll write T2 by T1. So we'll have a relation of time from this. Like the question is, if it is after what time the same volume diffuses. So T2 you have to find out according to density we can say. Okay? Even this we can relate with the moles and distance also. So this we can write what? The number of moles of A and B. That also we can NA by NB and then distance we can write. Okay? Case 2 you write down. Case 2 you write down. If the different value of volume of two gases diffuses in same time, if the different volume of two gases diffuses in same time, so rate we can write rate of diffusion R of A by R of B. Volume is same, right? Different volume. V1 by, so it is VA by VB. Is equals to, we can write root over of TV by TA. Time is same here, so T will get cancelled, volume will be there. Okay? If I say equal number of moles diffuses in different time, then also we'll get this. If we have different number of moles diffuses, then there will be NA by NB also, we can write that side. Means whatever the question is there, according to that, we'll write down the expression. Right?